he's getting players that Tennessee has not gotten in a long time. So he's learned from others, especially his old boss in Tuscaloosa. And I think he feels and senses the momentum, so he's playing to it. And no matter how you slice it, Jeremy Pruitt's recruiting has been the story of this spring. And the reason why I'm convinced that Tennessee is on the cusp of returning to power is I am hearing criticism from other schools, competing schools, from rivals, that he's not doing that great. Tennessee fans have been hungry and thirsty and have had a voracious appetite for a long time, and I think they're finally getting a return. Jeremy Pruitt is finally putting his imprint on this program.
Turns out Kenneth George's hands are as important as his feet, as we saw earlier, trying to fit it right here, and he had it. Watch now, right now, shook him. Ball's gonna come out, off target, gotta drop it in there better. Stevens, much like Schrader versus Auburn, overthrows an open receiver. That ball's too high to handle for Dedrick Thomas.
In this game of football,
UAB known more for its defense than offense in 2019. Johnson with a clean pocket, fires it in the seam, and it's picked off on the first play. Bryce Thompson comes out of there with it. What a start for Big Orange. Thompson still alive into the red zone. The first interception of the season for the sophomore from Irmo, South Carolina. And just
Boring's punt is blocked, and here come the Vols the other way. That's a touchdown. Romello Edwards blocked the kick, and the Vols score again. Make that Brandon Johnson. That's the backup wide receiver, a 24-yard return for a touchdown.
Special teams unit gets a star so far for the Vols. Get a great kickoff return. And then you get a block punt return for a touchdown, setting up the Tennessee Volunteers early in this game, jumping all over the box.
14-0 Tennessee. As you see Brandon Johnson recovering that kick after it was blocked by Jay Shoup, the defensive back, into the game, and special teams showing off for Tennessee.
Taking a shot towards the end zone for Grimes. It's tipped and intercepted. Alante Taylor on the carom gets a pick. And it's another takeaway for the Tennessee defense, their third.
Kyle Trask been a little bit indecisive on this drive. Tried to fit the ball in with the safety in the middle of the field. Alante Taylor trailing behind as Jackson's there at contact. Grimes trying to go up and make a play, and Alante Taylor there for the tipped pick.
Pick that up on the fly. Third and five, Missouri brings the house. Garantano is able to find Jennings. Jennings loses one tackler, then a second, and he takes it all the way into the end zone. 16 yards as Juwan Jennings fights for a Tennessee score.
Wow. A ball player. Second time we've seen Juwan Jennings make a monster play after the catch. And again, just too much cushion. I mean, Missouri's a team that lives and dies off pressing on the outside. But in the slot is where Tennessee is attacking this defense because there is not press coverage. There's cushion. And Juwan Jennings had a lot of space to work with on that play.
So Maglia punches it through. Tennessee hasn't missed a point after since 2014. 13-play drive capped by this.
Tagovailoa to throw for it. Gets some pressure. He's all the way back at the 20. Throws, and it's intercepted at the goal line. Intercepted by Nigel Warrior. Down the sideline, running out of gas, and he'll be taken down by Henry Ruggs.
That extended the drive. He gets the sack here as Charlton punts from his own end zone. It's a beauty, and sends Callaway back to his own 36. He's got two career punt returns for touchdowns. Make it three. Yards.
So you get denied the end zone on your red zone possession on fourth down. Then your defense comes out, stones your opponent's offense, forces them to try to get a punt away, try to pick up field position, and one of the best punt return men, if you give him a shot at it, Callaway can hurt you. That was basically the touchdown the Vols didn't get on offense on their previous possession.
10-7 Tennessee. You get the sack on third down from Daryl Taylor. And then Joe Charlton outkicks his coverage, and Callaway makes him pay.
Certainly quite intense, but his athletic director, who's new on the job, Malcolm Turner, came out a few weeks ago and said that Derek Mason's our coach moving forward. Hand off to Gray. There he goes in the open field. He's got a long way to go. To the 20, to the 10. Give him 6, 94 yards. And 71 yards rushing for the true freshman. Point after is good. Eric Gray came in with 207 yards rushing all season. Now with 171. A 94 yarder, a 56 yarder, and this is the last one right here. Get used to seeing number three, folks.
Got to make sure that you know and understand your protection. That time he was picked up.
Charlton in kick formation.
Schamberger picked up. That's nice and clean pocket. Just, that's a bad ball from Ryan Horitzky.
It's blocked! The Volunteers cover it in the end zone. Touchdown! Daniel Batuli.
Yeah.
the block and the touchdown. And oh, by the way, he has 15 tackles too.
My goodness. Not to be outdone. Juwan Jennings doing it all. Marquez Callaway with the punt return. Daniel Batuli said, I want in on the action. A block punt, a recovered for a touchdown. And Daniel Batuli and the balls are rolling.
Name me a quarterback, and they're rotating into the game right now. JT Schrout under center on second and nine. From Brian Maurer.
They come up with big catches.
It's a 10-point lead as Brent Samaglia makes the extra point. The redshirt freshman from Santa Clarita, California, JT Schrout, throws his first college touchdown, 55 yards. It'll be second down. Mississippi State's going to have to start thinking about timeouts. Meanwhile, Garantano, who's been told he cares too much, he doesn't get rid of the play that just happened. He keeps thinking about it. Trey Smith, his old roommate, the left guard, said that he constantly told Jared, forget about it, move on. He did on that third down conversion.
So just milk that clock down. Use all the play clock you can.
Bird. First guy to greet Brian Maurer, or to Garantano on the field rather, was Brian Maurer. Chris Winkie gets a hug. Samaglia's extra point is good. That's the longest drive of the season, 91 yards. And that guy, Tyler Bird, didn't have a catch before today. He's had a couple of game winners in his career. This one might be one too.
To the locker room with a knee injury. Thought maybe he was done for the day. He's got a big brace on that right knee, but just does a great job of staying home here on the left side and eating up a big physical running back in Christopher Rodriguez.
Fourth and goal. Here's the game. Kentucky trailing.
And Bowden is lining up at slot right now.
He'll motion back in to get in the shotgun in front of Rodriguez. Option. Bowden keeps it, and he's stopped! Tennessee turns Kentucky over on downs for the third time this half. Daniel Batuli has dominated this game defensively for Tennessee. He's got 19 tackles for the Volunteers. None bigger than this.
They try to get Bolden on the edge, but Batuli and Tennessee stretch this out. That's what you want to do against an option. Stretch it out to the sideline as much as possible. And a monster stop for Tennessee. We'll be rejoined in a moment by Holly Rowe. Delighted to have you with us. And Todd, the story for Tennessee, a new starting quarterback right after 18 straight starts by Jarrett Garantano. They've gone tonight to a true freshman in Brian Maurer. Here's the information you need to know about Brian Maurer, true freshman, prolific passer at Westport High School in Ocala, Florida, where he set the county record for passing yards in a season last year, better than 3,500.
They have some good-looking wide receivers and tight ends. They just have not consistently got them the football here in the first part of the year.
Maurer given time, throwing deep, and has an open receiver. Marquez Callaway all the way, touchdown Tennessee. That's Maurer's mother, Kyle Lester, who likes the second series of this game a lot more for the Tennessee offense than she enjoyed the first. 73 yards, their longest play of the year.
Well, they really fooled Richard LeCount, a veteran safety, on a little double move there for the touchdown.
Here's Brent Samaglia to tie it. Outstanding kicker. Both of these teams have one of the best kickers in the country. We're tied at 7. Well, we have a development down in Miami. Let's send you back to Matt Berry. Wow, wild game. Virginia Tech led at one point 28-0. And the Tennessee Volunteers needed something like that.
Absolutely. I mean, that's the kind of juice. Listen to this crowd. I mean, you got to do something to get the crowd in. Get them behind you. Get your team feeling good, because it's been an ugly start for this football team.
Well, we spoke with the head coach, Jeremy Pruitt, the offensive coordinator, Jim Chaney, for Tennessee yesterday.
Maurer, what he did on this play. First of all, he got great protection. Callaway is going to be up here at the top. He's going to run a double move in and then go. And the guy who's going to get beat is that veteran safety, Richard LeCount. Watch him break on the in route and lose deep leverage. And the protection was good enough to allow Maurer to launch that ball down the field. That one was perfectly thrown. And Callaway, we mentioned they've got some good wideouts. And that's the kind of play the Volunteers needed early in this football game.
You see the energy in Maurer. Coach Chaney said he has some juice.
Yeah, than he was being the starter in this one here at home.
Maybe some of mom's friends are letting her know she got some air time. Yeah, Brian Maurer came off the bench to start the second half in their last game. Each of these.
I think the difference is you could have seen that coming with Lawrence. Last year with Joe Burrow, nobody saw it coming. Get a new offense, one that he's more comfortable in, and voila.
Yeah, and speak about being comfortable. I mean, just look at the poise that he has had all season long, and as the expectations have risen, he just seems unfazed by it. And I don't think you have to look any further than last week's game, the semifinal. Even afterwards, it just seemed like he just went out for a jog.
Onside kick. Tennessee has a chance, and Gray gets it. Paxton Brooks with the perfect dribbler, and Tennessee's got the momentum now, trailing by 6 with the ball.
What a call by Jeremy Pruitt. Just needs to go 10 yards. Excellent execution with the kick. And that looks like it goes 10 yards to me. Wow.
Don't pay too much attention to the left foot of Eric Gray. It's where the ball is, not where the player is. Just like a touchback on a punt. Pac-12 replay crew taking a long look at it.
Hey, 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 hey.
tell you what, Eric Gray, who's had a nice night in the backfield, true freshman, I think he does an excellent job here of just waiting a little bit. I don't think there's enough that you could ever overturn that. I believe that goes 10 yards. Good patience by Gray. Outstanding kick. Incredible call.
So Michael McCabe has a headset on, talking with the Pac-12 crew up in the booth. No centralized replay in the bowl season until you get to the national championship game. So they're looking at it with looks that we're giving them from our television truck. Tom Allen trying to get Indiana to keep this momentum. David Lambro and Dave Pachinski, two replay officials tonight.
I think Eric Gray does an amazing job not extending his hands. He's patient to let this ball come to him. Look at him here. Kind of lets it get into his body, which allows it to go the 10 yards.
And he's doing it with an Indiana player within 3 yards of him. The awareness and the ability combined.
Yeah, and how about Jeremy Pruitt? Now you think about how this season started for Tennessee. The fact that they've, you know, won their last five. This game has not gone the way that I'm sure they planned on it going. They played two quarterbacks.
After review, the ruling on the field of illegal recovery by the kicking team stands as called. Game clock operator, please reset the game clock to 4:19.
So here we go, 4:20 to go. Garantano found rhythm by going to the running back out of the backfield last drive. How do you get him to find that same rhythm on this drive?
You know, Jeremy Pruitt talked about his team had faced some adversity, you know, even in the wins, and he thinks that his young team has kind of built up some calluses and handled it the right way. And you know, I think his quarterback is pretty, you can describe him that way also.
Gray has a huge hole, and he's got a touchdown. Gray recovered the onside kick to start this drive, and now he takes it in from 16 yards out. The Hoosiers, who missed an extra point earlier this game, now face the chance to fall behind if Tennessee can make theirs. Here's Brent Smaglia. Tennessee hasn't missed an extra point in 5 years. And that'll continue for the time being. And Tennessee reclaims the lead up one with Peyton Ramsey ready to get back on the field.
A good call by Jim Chaney, offensive coordinator for Tennessee, because Indiana really playing pass. And by playing pass, one of the things you can do when a team is kind of getting after, trying to confuse you, you can split them in the run game. Little double team here by the center and right guard. And then watch Trey Smith as he gets out into space here. Gets a good block there, cover up, which allows Eric Gray to cut it up inside. Talked about this offensive line for Tennessee, kind of leaning on this defense of Indiana, wearing them down a little bit. These big bodies for Tennessee. But honestly, that's what's happening. Then you split them in the run game while Indiana's expecting pass.
Redemption for Garantano.